Domestic and Family Violence Prevention Month is an annual event held each May to raise awareness of the impacts of family violence. On average, one woman is killed by a current or former partner in Australia every week. This issue also affects men and children. The AFL's Executive General Manager of Inclusions and Social Policy joined Megan Waters to discuss the most complex and urgent issue of our time.
Tanya Hosch, thank you so much for joining us again on Yokayi Footy. It's always great to have you on the show. Now, domestic violence is an epidemic that is showing absolutely no signs of slowing down. Why do you think it's on the rise now?
Yeah, I wonder if it's on the rise or if it's just getting greater attention, to be honest. I think it's been a problem in society for a very long time. I remember when I was in my early 20s working at the Women's Information Switchboard in Adelaide. We were a 12-hour service set up by a generation of feminist women designed to help women with any need they had. And, you know, in that time, I still recall, you know, probably 85% of calls were about sexual assault or family violence in some way, shape or another. And I remember then trying to refer women to services where they could escape violence with their children, and there were just never enough beds and never enough services to deal with the amount of violence that women were experiencing in their home.
Well, that's it. Statistically, they say, isn't it, 1 in 4 women experience domestic violence. So when you strip that back to, you know, your friendship circles or your family circles, it's pretty terrifying. Why does the community need to be aware of this problem in society?
Well, because I think you can't solve a problem you don't talk about, and certainly you can't solve a problem you don't know anything about. The other point I always like to make is that when we're talking about violence against Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander women, I think it's really important to remind people that that doesn't mean that the perpetrator is an Aboriginal or Torres Strait Islander man, that women are abused by people of all cultures.
Statistically, there is research to prove that there has been rises in domestic violence, particularly over the grand final weekend in the AFL and in other sporting codes. Do you have any comments to make on that?
Yeah, Megan, it's a really good call out, I think. I think for some years now we've known that there does seem to be an increased amount of reporting of domestic violence incidents in that weekend of the grand final. I think that, you know, the grand final itself is not the cause of that violence. But, you know, there's a lot of activities that go on with, you know, the grand final weekend. It's a cause of a lot of social gatherings and people coming together. And sometimes that can involve excessive drinking, also excessive gambling, which can all create a pressure valve. But, you know, none of those things are an excuse for violence, and we certainly stand strongly against it.
Clearly something needs to be done to keep women and children safe from these behaviours. What could be some of the solutions to this societal issue?
Definitely we need to put a lot more work into prevention, and that's why the relationship the AFL has with Our Watch has become so important, because they do really great work in relation to getting preventative messages out there, making sure that people are educated and understand what is acceptable behaviour and what is not. And there's a whole range of other organisations doing similar work. Interestingly, I've known a lot of people who've told me that growing up, you know, there was violence in their home, and part of the way they escaped that was to play sport, was to busy themselves all weekend playing different sports just to be active and away from that environment.
And how does the AFL's respect and responsibility policy that you were so instrumental in creating actually tie into this discussion?
Certainly, as we've renewed the policy, we were able to make, you know, considerable improvement to it, including a really clear triage system. So any incident or report comes straight to the AFL. It doesn't sit with a club to manage, and it's dealt with through our integrity department. It's much more complainant and victim-centred now. So really listening to the victim and the complainant about how they want it resolved, the kind of support we put in place for victims that can last for some time. If it ends up being a criminal-related matter that they're reporting, then the AFL integrity department will support them to make a police report. We don't investigate as the police do, but certainly we have a responsibility in terms of our code of conduct once a matter might be resolved.
Well, thank you so much for the important work that you do. And thank you so much for taking the time to come on Yokayi Footy again and chat with us today.
Anytime. Thanks.
What a brilliant and important discussion there. Really well led there, Megzy. Tanya Hosch is an absolute superstar DJ. Such an important, I guess, issue that needs to be worked on so hard from all types of members of community.
Yeah, you're exactly right. There's a lot of different groups doing a lot of good stuff. Look, the numbers are horrific, but NT radio media personality Charlie King has done a program for about 10 to 15 years now with footy players in the Northern Territory, and they actually link the arms before the game, which has been, you know, in solidarity and defiance against domestic violence. So that's been a real good focus point up there, and it's been really good. And telling young players and young men to speak up and speak out, and even young women in that thing, in that regard. Megzy, what's your take on all this?
Well, that's it, DJ. Like you said, speaking up, I think, is so important, and it's an area that I'm so passionate about, raising awareness. Like you said, the stats are horrifying, and it's an area that is really personal to me. My mum actually still works. She's worked for the last 19 years in the Northern Territory in Darwin for an Aboriginal domestic violence shelter. And the, you know, over the last 6 months, she said that it's actually gotten worse than she's ever seen, and it's just something that's not going away. And so it is really important that we are, you know, having these conversations and raising the awareness and putting the work in to ensure that, you know, we can somehow start to reduce these numbers and statistics.
Yeah. And you're right, Tia, you're exactly right. 82% of women, 97% of men who experience violence from a current partner never contact the police, so we don't know.
And if this discussion has raised any issues for you or it's triggering in any way, if you're concerned or know someone, please, please call 1-800-RESPECT or visit their website.
For counselling advice and support for men who have anger, relationship or parenting issues, call the Men's Referral Service or visit ntv.org.au.